Okay, so as discussed before, here we'll be looking at how do we convert recurring decimals to fractions. So we'll be looking at three distinct kind of examples in terms of how we do it. So basically they cover all the different situations which could arise in a recurring decimal. So the first situation is we have to find the p upon q form of 3.5555 and so on. So 5 is the recurring part here. Now note that I have written here the recurring decimal part of the decimal is represented by a bar above it. So in this case, as 5 is the recurring part, let this whole number be equal to x. So x could be represented as 3.5 and there has to be a bar above 5, which basically represents that 5 is the recurring part. Now how do we convert it into a p upon q form? We look at how many digits are in the recurring part. So here we have only one digit in the recurring part, which is a 5. So we simply multiply it with 10 raised to power whatever the number of digits in the recurring part are there. In this case, as there is only one digit, we multiply it by 10 and we get 10x as 35.5 bar, because this 5 bar is anyways in, we have infinite 5s here. So this will still remain. Now if we subtract x from this 10x, so we have 10x minus x, we will have 35.5 bar minus 3.5 bar. So this way we are able to remove this recurring part, and 35 minus 3 is 32. This is equal to 9x. So x is nothing but 32 upon 9, which is a required p upon q form. So this is how we convert this simple recurring decimal into a p upon q fraction form. So now we'll be looking at the second example here. So here we have x equal to 0.142857 and then 142857, 142857. So it is getting recurring after 6 digits. So 6 digits are the number of digits which are recurring, which are in the recurring part. So we multiply x by 10 raised to power 6x. So we get 142857, again 0.142857, and this will again be recurring bar. So now we simply do 10 to the power 6 minus 1. So we subtract this x value from this one to remove the recurring part. We will get 142857, because 142857 minus 0 is 142857 and this decimal part cancels out with this decimal part. So we are left with only this. So next we write 142857 upon 10 to the power 6 minus 1 is 999999. So it comes 6 times. If we simplify this, we'll see that this is actually a factor of this and we'll get a simplified form of 1 upon 7. So 1 upon 7, this was actually the recurring decimal of 1 upon 7 itself. So 1 upon 7 is the required P upon Q form. Now we'll be looking at another final example from this lecture. So here we have x equal to 0.2345 4545 45. So basically the 45 is the recurring part here. So we'll write x equal to 0.23 and the bar only comes above 45 because that is the recurring part. Now here what we do is we will have to first multiply by 100 to have all the recurring part after the decimal. So we have 100x equal to 23.45 and the bar comes above 45. Now what we do is we again multiply it by 100 more to get 10000x. So 10000x becomes 2345 minus this is 45. And once again, the 45 is in the recurring part. Now we subtract 100x from 10,000x. So we will have 9,900x equal to 2345 minus 23, and the recurring part gets cancelled out. So here we are left with, so 2, 3, 2, 2. This is what we are left with in the right hand side. So therefore x is nothing but 2, 3, 2, 2 upon 9900. Note that this further can be simplified, but we don't have to do it here because we have already got the answer in P upon Q form, which was the required form of the given recurring decimal. So this is how we convert these kind of forms.